Welcome back to Let's Play Disco Elysium Blind. That's my partner. Still looking around here. Actually got this guy. Forget his name. He sells clothes and shoes and speakers. I have a feeling we're gonna need the speakers for something, but I don't know what. We got him to give us $10 or 10 real or whatever. Roy's Pawn Shop. Fast cash for faster times. I guess that's Roy. Water lock out of order until Wednesday, 7:15 a.m. There's more trash container. Fingerless gloves, plus one electrochemistry. That's interesting. Gasoline-stained fingerless gloves in navy blue. They've been worn threadbare, but being made of wool still provides some warmth and comfort. Okay, this one gives you plus one interfacing. This gives plus one electrochemistry. I guess we'll hold on to them. Okay. A plastic bottle we can sell. What's this? Water lock control panel. A couple of indicator lights are missing from this control panel. Loose wires dangle from the now vacant holes. In the middle is a lever. Beneath it, a small metal plaque. Visual calculus says this panel usually closes the water lock, turning it into a bridge that lets you cross the canal, but there's a crashed Samarin butter sign in the way. Pulling the lever probably won't do anything. Pull it anyway. You pull the lever all the way up until the metal clinks against the contact pins. You hear a soft clunk, and then nothing happens. Push it harder. Nothing happens. A cold gust of wind blowing in from the sea interrupts the silence of the situation. Mm-hmm. Lieutenant hums to himself while staring at your activities. Release the lever. New task. Close the water lock on Wednesday. What day is it now? A spring brings the lever back to its original position. You still need to close the water lock to get across the canal some other way. Perception says, wasn't there a sign over there saying functionality will be restored on Wednesday morning? Leave. Okay, so it's Monday now. To get to the coast, you need to use the panel to close the water lock. It's been blocked, pending repairs, which should be done by Wednesday morning. This will open up a new area in Martinez. Cool. I kind of like that they blocked at least some of it off, because I want to look all over first before dealing with the mob by the factory or whatever the hell it is, the yard. Let's talk to this guy. Evening, officers. A burly man hangs out by the water lock, carving up a generous serving of salami with an old hunter's knife. His eyes are fixed on a man stranded on the other side of the water lock and on an enormous billboard that has fallen down into the canal between them. Do you know what caused this this wreckage? Pointing at the smashed billboard. I wasn't here to witness it, but those look like tire tracks on that sign. Weird, huh? Then again, plenty of daredevil drivers in Revachol. Inland Empire says, the words daredevil driver sound ominous to you. Too bad it also takes a year and a day to repair anything around here, especially a water lock. The rest of the coast is closed off till then. What's with the lever that does nothing? It's supposed to operate the water lock, but as noted, it's all junk right now. Disabled because of the blockage. Why is it disabled? Safety measure. Turns out the panel needs a special key to be reactivated. Wouldn't want anyone moving the water lock with debris still in the channel. It'll be restarted on Wednesday morning. He nods his head towards the control panel. You want to do the honors when the time comes? Well, do I ever, nodding enthusiastically. Great. Just drop in on Wednesday if you want to see the water lock at work. They say the canal crew will be here 7:15 a.m. He cuts a fresh slice from his salami. The coast part of the map is inaccessible until the third day. Do you know what's further down the coast? Well, there's the fishing village, an abandoned fish market, a bizarro church. Not much use to the congregation, though. There always seems to be something wrong with it. Can I have some of that salami? Sure thing. He cuts off a slice of salami while we yield zero. Want some too, officer? He turns to the lieutenant. The lieutenant ponders the offer for a moment, then decides to go for it. Why not? He takes a slice of salami from the man and chews on it. All right, right, bye. Okay. Now this is the pawn shop. Oh wait, he wants to talk. I don't click that, I click him.
We should think about calling it a day, maybe. The nights are still miserably cold this time of year.
There's just one problem. I haven't paid the cafeteria manager for damages yet. You should take care of that, then. But I don't have the money. Let's talk to him anyway. An officer of the RCM shouldn't be sleeping in the streets. We'll figure something out. Empathy says, though he finds the situation frustrating, he is doing his best to not make you feel any worse than you already do. Pay for damages. Try negotiating with the cafeteria manager. Yeah, the station for additional funds did not work out. Can we just go in here first since we're already here? I don't know if they're open for business. Pawn shop, right? Welcome to the pawn shop, yep. Some kind of machine, an antique cash register? Protective thing. A bust of a woman. The plaque simply says Dell. In the dark, a film projector is whirring away. Welcoming me over and over again. Mostly military wear with a few eccentric fashions thrown in. What's that? Sawed-off streetlight. A typical Martinet streetlight sits among assorted floor and table lamps. The light pole has been carefully cut, and the wiring has been redone and attached to a standard indoor plug. The light buzzes faintly but persistently. Conceptualization says this would make a great statement in your living room. Is that a streetlight? Yes, officer. As you can see, it's in perfect working order. Bird's Nest Roy. Where did you get this? It was brought to me to be altered. Kim says he leans in so the pawnbroker wouldn't hear him. We're not here to investigate the theft of city property. He pauses, studying the light, then adds, you have to admit, it's rather clever when he's done with it. How much for the street light? 700 real. A bargain, I dare say. Are you out of your mind? There's one just like that on every corner. He rests his elbows on the counter, and brings his face closer to the glass. The light has undergone three transformations, and every transformation, large or small, has a price tag. Logic says the light has been removed and rewired. That's two transformations, but what about the third? I get how sawing it off and redoing the wiring could add to the cost, but what else? He throws you a look of weary patience. The most important transformation is the light's placement among ordinary indoor fixtures, which has adjusted its morphological field. The light became suitable for use inside the home just a few days ago. Conceptualization says, okay, that checks out. Something else you need to know about the light. Shelf of boomboxes. The boomboxes on the shelf look well-loved and well-traveled. Chipped, dented, they stare at you with the unblinking eyes of their tape reels. Stand on the tips of your toes to see more. One especially catches your eye, deep gold and amber plastic with a big old handle on top. A classic boombox that says Stereo 8 approved. Inland Empire says, this is you, gold and orange, a sunset suite. Interfacing says, just make sure it works before you buy it. Shopkeep, this Stereo 8 approved machine here is the Harman Wowshi W02 made in Vesper, designed in Seoul, whatever. He says, plays all reel-to-reel formats, 2mm, 8mm, 12mm. It's even got a little radio in there. It'll set you back 12 real. Are you sure this is all in working order? Absolutely. I've tested each one myself with recordings of speech, found sounds, and music from a variety of genres, even though, he grimaces, I don't really like music. Any music? Yeah, conceptualization says that's odd. Why doesn't he like music? Don't like music? What do you like then? The stuff I record myself, silverware shaking in drawers as motor cars race by, nocturnal animals climbing on the roof, airship rotors, that kind of thing. Huh. Maybe you should ditch music as well. Get into these more experimental sounds he's describing. What I really want to know is, could this device come in handy in my police work? If police work means playing tapes, sure. You could use it for that, or any other time you need to play a tape. Alright. That's all for that. So this, what is that, a broken cabinet? Knick-knack stand. You see rows of tiny soldiers guarding the rest of the trinkets displayed on the table. Some on horseback, others in rags, others yet in bright blue uniforms. All are stern and unyielding in their duty. Inland Empire says, try to find something pretty and cool here, then use it to win her back. Win her back? Yes, buy something nice, a figurine. Who's her? Inspect the knights on horseback. Big men on big horses clad in lamellar armor and carrying flintlocks, the kind that would mow down a line of enemy soldiers in the blink of an eye. Points at the knights on horseback. Who are they? Kim says, Frankon Nigerian knights. He looks at the dusty figurines in the dim light. I used to be very serious about these guys. Esprit de Corps says, a long, long time ago. Inspect the blue uniforms. They're not all blue. These figurines also wear gold coats and caps, complemented by orange trousers. They are variously posed, wielding swords and rifles with bayonets. It looks like René, the old guy who was playing petanque. This is what the loyalists look like, yes. Kim inspects the figurine. At first, then they wisened up and got camouflage. What exactly are these? Roy says, which ones? The man peers from his glass box. Ah, royalist soldiers from the time of the revolution. The uniforms are painted a bit too brightly, I suppose. Inspect the figurines in rags. This set of soldiers isn't meant to look impressive. A few have rifles, but most of them carry pistols. Some even shovels and tall sticks. Are these even soldiers? You're probably talking about the revolutionaries, yes? The man behind the glass answers, yes, they're soldiers. Revolutionary soldiers. I think their poverty has been exaggerated for effect. When you place them next to the Royalists, it doesn't seem like they could possibly win. It's meant to give people hope. Even we can do it. Maybe. Dig up a truly cool figurine in the box under the table. Interfacing high. Failed. Everything you pick out seems faded, chipped, and sad somehow. Most of them are just broken toys. Psst. Rhetoric says. Look around. Rhetoric says, psst, hey you. Who, me? Yes, you. Word on the street is you're ready to start building communism again. Again? Yes, you're ready to start building communism again. You've built it before, they've built it before. Hasn't really worked out yet, but neither has love. Should we just stop building love, too? Can't argue with that. So what about all that communism you promised to build? Word on the street is that you've woken up from 1,000 years of slumber, promising to erect a version of communism many times greater than any attempted before. Is that true? How come there's word on the street? You keep saying things like, down with the bourgeois, eat the rich, sodomize the landowners, impale all people who have more than 25 real in their pocket, literally murder all human beings regardless of their political beliefs, that kind of stuff. I haven't said anything like that. Okay, not in so many words, but don't deny it. You're about to rip off that mask of social democracy and reveal the monstrous seven-eyed lamb of global communism that will devour and masticate mankind. Everyone can see that. So tell me, do you have any questions before you fire up the big communism builder? Or do we get right down to it? Wait first, what's this communism even about? Failure. It's about failure. Failure? Well, yes, abject failure. Total irreversible defeat on all fronts. Absolutely vanquished, beaten, curb-stomped, and pissed on until you came along. You will reverse the fortune of the workers of the world. You alone, against every living thing, against every human alive, 800 trillion real in the hands of an impossibly well-organized ruling class, towering city blocks of bank men who have the ears of prime ministers, million-headed armies of nations, and the love of your own mother. You, against the atom, the charm, and the spin, where the whole world failed, matter failed to bend to human will failed to get out of bed and tie its laces, you alone single-handedly will rebuild the dreams of the working class. You are the last communist. What the hell? Now get to work, comrade. It's too tiring. I don't have it in me. I'm beat down and broken. Opt out. I'm not really interested in doing it, is what it really is. Very well, I guess no one will build communism then. Tell the working man it's over, unless anyone has objections. Logic says no objections. It's mathematically impossible to achieve a classless society. Everyone knows this. Rhetoric says anyone? Anyone else? There's no one? There's no one. Okay then. Lie down and let the water carry you downstream. Goodbye, communism. Whatever. So we're talking to this guy.
It's not often that I see officers of the RCM in my pawn shop.
The man at the counter turns to you slowly, so you do have a voice.
What can I do for you?
Empathy says, his courtesy is not insincere, but he prefers being alone with his projector, just watching the movement of light across the walls of the shop. Sorry, I feel like I'm interrupting you.
Oh no, not at all. I guess I haven't had many customers lately. RCM or otherwise.
He flashes a smile.
Who are your customers usually?
All kinds of people come through here. Locals, travelers, people looking for a deal, people looking for a keepsake, people who are terminally bored. As you can see, I have a wide selection of goods for everyone to choose from.
Nod. Quite the collection indeed.
It keeps me entertained.
His attention is drawn once more to the play of light and shadow on the walls behind you. I don't want to sell that trinket. The pin she gave me. You might be able to aid our investigation. I doubt it, but I can try to answer any questions you may have. Know anything about the recent hanging? I do my best to keep my distance from all manner of butchery. Bad for business, bad for everyone. Drama says he doesn't know anything. Think you could help me get a corpse out of a tree? The corpse behind the hostel, I assume. He looks into the swirling lights, then to you. I don't have a truck with a mounted platform or anything of that sort myself. Ask around the harbor. There might be some workers who'd be willing to help. The pawnbroker's gaze is already fixed on the dancing colors. Do you happen to have any guns like the ones carried by officers of the citizens' militia? Someone else came here earlier today asking the same question. I promptly sold her the gun you pawned a couple days back. What? I pawned a gun. Logic says, is this a pawn shop? And it did feel as if you've met before. Oh, God. Kim, the lieutenant, shifts from 1 foot to another, alert. Wait, I sold you my gun? You were adamant about getting rid of it, officer. He hesitates. Said you were undeserving of a service weapon of the Revachol Citizens Militia. And I don't like keeping guns around the shop for long. Off the charts photon emissions, the unhealthy kind. Empathy says he's not telling you the whole story. It seems he's trying to spare you. I feel there's something you're not telling me. Looks away. You weren't quite yourself, officer. What was I like? You were very distraught. You said the gun was a threat to your life and that you can't trust yourself with it tonight. And you need the money. When I said I don't normally buy firearms, you put the gun barrel in your mouth and sort of sucked on it. Then I agreed to take it. Wait, how much did I sell the gun for? 15 real. The lieutenant looks from you to Roy and then back to you. It's clear that he hopes this tableau might still turn out to be a bad dream. It's not, though. Esprit de Corps says this has got to be the most... Wow. Empathy says there's pity there, too, in case you didn't notice. I'm so sorry you had to see me in that state. We don't have to talk about it any further. No apologies necessary, officer. Well, we are going to talk about it further. Was the buyer a policeman, too? She didn't seem like a policeman, although she kept referring to herself as a pig, which was odd. I found her interest in the gun a bit obsessive, but I was just happy to get rid of it. And of her. Truth be told, she was terrifying. Kim says, right, so let me get this right. The lieutenant turns to you. You sold your sidearm, issued by the citizens militia, and now a civilian is running around the streets of Martinez with it. Empathy says, miraculously, his face does not reveal what's happening inside. Must be good composure he has. I'm sorry. I'm sorry I sold my gun. Kim sighs. Yeah, it's not good. I do hope we manage to clean this mess up somehow, while also keeping our focus on the murder investigation. Empathy says, this mess. He means your mess. Any idea where I can find this buyer? My apologies, officer, but I have no idea where she was coming from or where she went. Logic says, a needle in a haystack. There's nothing you can do about it now. You just have to hope you luck upon her somehow. At least now I know I lost my sidearm. Let's talk about something else. Of course. Something I like to... No, I'm not gonna... We'll try this. Probably gonna fail, but is Roy high? And if yes, then what is he on? Fail, of course. Okay, definitely is high. Whatever it is, you've probably done it, and many other things besides. But you can't cut through the jumble of sensations to get to the answer. Logic says, looking at his wares, talking to him, that might give you some clues. I already did. A guarded man like him wouldn't tell you if you asked out loud. Alright. Suggestion. We don't hear from Suggestion often. Or at all. Hey, we've been monitoring you internally, and we know how... We know you're a capo type. Wait, there are capo types? Yes. Guess what's yours? I was kind of hoping I'm the superstar cop. That's only a ludicrous daydream. Guess again, you're the... Sorry cop? I'm sorry, I'm not sure. Yes, sorry cop. The cop who's sorriest. Let's make it official then, shall we? Empathy says, huge lack of enthusiasm going on in here. Won't the other capo types be jealous? What? Jealous of the sorry cop? I think they'll be fine. Don't worry. They'll be super duper fine. Conceptualization says it'll be totally okay. You can dual capo type from sorry to anything. Oh. They should be sorry. Yes, yes. Impotent rage and lamentation. Let's wrap it up. Okay, I'm sorry. Thought gain, rigorous self-critique. Of course you are. It's okay. See if you can get something out of this, like info, or maybe every time you say you're sorry, you get $1 million. Logic says, that won't happen. Track down your gun. Someone must know something about your lost firearm. Maybe a district authority, like someone high up in the union, or someone local who saw you with it before you passed out. The whirling's absent bartender? You could also ask the local pawn shop. Well, we did ask that, so... Keep looking, maybe someone else knows something. And we have, some kind of... No, we're not doing that one. Rigorous self-critique. It's a temporary research bonus to -1 authority. I think I'll pass on it, at least for now. I don't think I want -1 authority. You're one sorry piece of crap. A cop penitent, a flagellant cop monk. This is not the right line of work for you. You should be groveling at the feet of a feudal lord, providing lurid evidence against yourself as a Mazovian show trial, at a Mazovian show trial, or ripping the flesh from your back with a cat of nine tails. Whatever made you this way, you can be damn sure it was your own fault. Do it. Really criticize yourself. Who knows? You might uncover something of importance from your guilt-ridden past. I'm gonna hold on it for now, at least. Alright, let's get out of here. Let's see, head back to the hotel. What we got here? Nazifed. Nice. Okay. Luckily we're close by. Oh wait, in here. Let's see if we can work out our issue. Of the tab we owe. Equip a flashlight in low light areas. Oh, I do have one. Well, these people are here. Well, this guy, we can't talk to him. We can't talk to any of them. Wasn't this guy that he wouldn't really say much to us? It's all about money, you know? I think these are the people that we might have been waiting to pick up. We can just take this bottle here? Is that his bottle? Or he just dropped it? Oh, we got money back here, wait. Nice, another 50. I got almost all the money I need. Can't talk to any of these people. Alright, let's see if we can work something out.
Can I help you?
So about that money I owe. Yes, have you got it? I was wondering, how much do I owe you again? A lot. A lot. For the room, drinks, and a broken window, 130 real. Here I thought it was 30 real. I was wondering if you could come to some sort of arrangement for tonight. Does that arrangement include you paying me what we already agreed you owe me? Kim's about to say something. Let him. He adjusts his glasses. I understand your predicament as the manager. However, I feel I must remind you that we are here to conduct an important investigation that also affects your business. Forgive me for saying this, but your colleague seems more committed to drinking and... He stops mid-sentence. I mean no offense. It's really nothing personal. I just have to protect the interests of this establishment. Hold on, I still have my key, you know. Good luck trying to use it. He taps his foot against a metal box installed in the back of the counter. All the locks here have an electronic component. They have to be unlocked down here with a master key before your guest key will open the lock. This conversation isn't going anywhere, is it? Not until you bring me the money. Kim says, okay. He turns to you with a heavy sigh. I might have something in my motor carriage we can use when you're done here. Speedacore says, I really didn't want to resort to this. The man is thinking. Oh, Lieutenant, we're done here. Okay. Let's go get this then. Pay for damages. Kim has offered to help. Go to his motor carriage in front of the whirling. Open it or just talk to him? I have something here we could sell. Look in the back, in the suspect transport enclosure. Transport enclosure, Reaction Speed says. Regular people just call it the cage. Let's look in it. The cage at the back of the motor carriage looks rather uncomfortable. Four shiny hubcaps are stacked against the seat. Their silver edges sparkle in the dark. I confiscated these for a little while back. We can take them to the pawn shop down by the Martinez Canal. What are those things? They're spinner hubcaps, frivolous things you put on your wheels. When the wheels come to a stop, he makes a spinning motion with his hands. The caps keep on spinning. There's no real use for them, it's just for vanity. What do you mean you confiscated them? A couple weeks ago, I stopped a young man for going slower than the speed of traffic. Turns out he was some Coalition official's son. And high. So you took his spinners? He nods. I took them and arrested him for driving under the influence. Isn't that corruption? I don't know, is it? The lieutenant looks back, stone-faced. I was going to take them into evidence, but they weren't necessary for conviction. He never asked for them back. Did you want to put these spinners on your machine? No, that would be silly. He hesitates. I don't know why I kept them. It doesn't matter. I couldn't put them on the MC anyway. A cop with spinners. That would be outrageous. Yes, outrageously cool. He flashes a smile, barely visible in the dark. I'm sorry you have to sell them because of me. As I said, they're useless anyway. I should have remembered I had these earlier. Esprit de Corps says, but thank you. Thanks, I appreciate your help. Take them. The lieutenant nods as you take the spinners. The magnificent hubcap spinners that Lieutenant Kitsuragi has donated to you so that you can pay for your room at the Whirling. They are slate blue and shimmer haughtily in the light. Take spinner hubcaps to local pawn shop south of the plaza. I wonder how much these babies will sell for.